People of the Hulk Life, this is Hulk. Get yourself, buddy. I can't see myself right now, Dad. You can see me, though. How do I look? You look handsome as ever. People of the Hulk Life, do you feel like you just came out of The Lion King? That's what that intro was supposed to make you feel. You were supposed to feel attached. You were supposed to feel like, welcome to the kingdom. That was the whole idea. Oh, there's a tantrum. I'm gone. I'm gonna go back this way. So anyways, yeah. Salute Brock Berrigan, man. That track is perfect. Got the message through exactly what I was trying to portray with that right there. So anyways, people, welcome to the Hulk Life. I'm going back into my office where I just came out of, because when my son sees me, he tends to throw tantrums. So I wasn't gonna add fuel to the fire, but I do need to go downstairs. It's alright. Welcome. Let's go on with our day. See how I tell you guys that they come and they push it up against you when you're teaching them this? See how he's literally pushing this on me? I'm like, all he wants me to do is this. This is all he wants. Because the game comes from the engagement with the dog. When there's no engagement, he wants me to engage with him. You see? So all I... No, you bit my leg. You bit my leg because you're pushing so hard and chewing. You chewed on my leg. You chewed on my leg for a second. Settle down. I know you're excited. I'm trying to explain to them. Okay, so anyways, yeah, they'll push up against you so much so that if they're doing this, that they'll actually chew on your leg a little bit. But the idea is when you're engaged with the dog, this is how I teach. This is the main platform of how I teach. So what I'm starting to teach the dog today is a little obedience. So you see I'm doing just a little circle, just teaching a little about the leash. Bring it to me, you see? So what I'm teaching the dog is that the engagement is all about me, not this. It's about me touching this, my engagement to this. So this is the main platform that I teach off of when I start to teach dogs obedience. And with my protection dogs, I don't teach obedience until late because my philosophy is it's very easy to tame a dog down. Okay, it's a lot harder to bring a dog out. So in the beginning, all I want is intensity, okay? But right now, I'm starting to teach this dog a little bit of obedience. A little bit of his out, which a little bit, you know, a little bit of heel, automatic sits, positioning with me, just the very basis. So that's what this vlog is about today. So continue to watch. Kobe out, out,
Colby, out! Good.
You see, I'm not even really using the correction. Is this at the, it's a, like I said, when you build a bond and a connection with a dog, it's very different. And that's one of the things that I always do with my dogs. Life. You have to build and strengthen the bond with the dog, then they trust you, you work very differently. So as you can see, I didn't even use a correction to turn it out. Just my voice. And we have eye contact, which is good. Foose. This is what we want. See how ridiculous this is? The key with dogs is repetition, okay? There is no secrets, there is no fast forwarding in this game. The key to this is repetition. So if you wanna train dogs, be ready to be on it all the time, all day, every day. That's where you get this from. You bond with them, you get real close and tight with the dogs, they trust you. That's what it's all about. Now don't let them fool you out there in the world, you know? This is not magic, you know? See this? I mean, this is consistent. This is consistent through all my training with all my dogs. This is how we deal with them. We engage them. We teach them to bond with us. So off this platform, I will show this dog amazing, amazing things. Even more than what he's done. He's going to soar this summer.
I definitely see Kobe being a star of the future, man. You can't dismiss qualities like that. He has what it takes.
Hit the river.
What are you gonna think? What about you?
Bro, how many times have I told you that you're extra handsome? Because you are, bro. You're extra handsome. Even with your little foot up in the air right now, your little foot up, you're pointing. Bro, you're just ridiculously handsome. It's ridiculous. I know. I just look at you and I'm like, my God. Look at this fella. Wow, look at that smile on this guy.
I'm sorry. I'm utterly obsessed with dogs.
If you are too and you love dogs, just give this video a like. And you love nature. You love life. You're a positive person. Give this video a thumbs up. That's what this is all about, you know? Despite media conception, you know, I mean, I live my life in a very peaceful manner.
He's like the peaceful spot right here. He's, I just like the sound of the rushing water. And be honest, it's the shortest walk from my house to the largest body of water. The other bodies of water that you see me at all the time, I have to walk kind of far to hike up the mountain. So I just like it, it's right here. It's like my little peace zone. I like to sit on that rock over there and just kind of gather my thoughts. But just out here after I was done training with Kobe, just some real basic stuff, you know, give you guys a little window into it. Again, as I keep saying, we're going to be coming out with the DVD. I made it entirely and then I scrapped it because I didn't like it. It felt dated. So we're doing another one. So I'm not going to give you too much, but just a little window because I'm starting his obedience. And basically, you know, what I was doing with him was introducing him to what we call the game, which is basically teaching him how to engage me and stay engaged all the time. And that, you know, when we're training, when the dog has a tug, you know, most dogs, they get a toy, they want to run off with it, they run around, they're excited, they have it, they shake it up, it's so exciting. But as you can see with my dogs, they don't actually care when they have the toy. As you can see, he's pushing it up against my leg, so much so that he was biting my leg almost because he was mouthing on it a little bit, which is something that I'll start to correct later. But you don't nitpick on every little thing. You know, his bite work is solid. His grip is amazing. So I don't worry about that. He likes to mouth on the jute a little bit. It is what it is. But he nibbles on my leg a little bit when he does it because he pushes up against you so much because all he wants is for me to be touching and tug, engage with him, tugging and playing. So what we teach them is off of that system, that's how they learn. And there really is actually, I mix it, you know, because it's supposed to be a method with no conflict. You know, I mix it with, you know, corrections sometimes because I just feel like it speeds up the process. And at this point, the way I do obedience, I do it at the end of protection. So a lot of time the dogs are extremely intense too. So, I mean, you're going to be in like lifelong battles, you know, just sitting there trying to, you know, basically see who's going to give up first. Because that's how you train the dogs with this off of it. You know, you teach them really that when it stops, it's no fun and eventually they'll let go. But a lot of the way these dogs are trained when you do the bite work first, their grip and their fight and what they're doing is so incredible that, I mean, you're just kind of working against yourself. So being experienced and being that, you know, my whole philosophy with dogs is about this here, water and flowing and changing. You know, I saw fit to the style and how I train when I use this method. I just tweak it a little bit depending on the dog. And, you know, I introduce corrections at different points while I'm teaching. But the whole basis of it is, as you see today, was just teaching them small out, just like a little bit about, you know, body positioning, you know, which, again, I don't compete. I don't do those kind of things. That's not what it's about for me. It's really about understanding that the dog is solid and understands the protection work. He's balanced, can go out in the world and do his job. You know, whether he sits perfectly to my left and looks at me, that's amazing. You know, we do a lot of the fancy stuff for, you know, for promos and it looks good. And yes, we can train like that, but it's just unnecessary with a lot of the ways that we train and a lot of things that we do. So it's not an area that I focus on extra detail there, because it's really irrelevant to what I do. You know, I focus on, you know, the protection work aspect and the dog understanding the true nature of what they're doing, you know. So the people of the Hope Life, it's just a quiet day today, you know. There's always a lot going on, but, you know, we keep you guys in happy land. That's what it's all about.
Big boy. Rumble, man. Bro, you're ridiculous, bro.
Rumble.
Rumble. Young man. You got big, fella. Fella. Oh, my God. Come on, man. Oh, my God. You just want to lay down. He's like, I'm just big. I'm heavy, dad. He just runs past, so he doesn't give a shit. It's like, yeah, this spot looks good. Flop. Bro, you look just like your brother, bro. Just like him. Handsome, brown, big. That's right. Friendly. That's right. Proper ambassador, just likes rolling in the grass. That's what he likes doing right now.
Such as...